Well, thank you so much. It's great to be here. I want to thank Bloomberg for the opportunity. And before I talk about the satellite revolution that I think is really going to make an enormous difference in what we can do to address climate change, I want to talk a little bit about the narrative about how I got to this point. I was first introduced to climate change as an undergraduate, and that really got me interested in following that, and that really became the focus of my academic career. I became a professor, and I worked on the climate impacts on forests. I did that for a couple of decades, really thinking about what was happening, where was that change occurring. But after a couple of decades, walking in the forest, looking in the forest, I realized that the rate of change was far faster than anything I had expected. That in fact, the change that I was seeing was what I thought would happen well past my lifetime. The need for change was urgent. And I decided to leave academia and go to the Environmental Defense Fund because I needed to focus less on the impacts and more on addressing the problem. So what I want to talk about today is the levers, the big hidden levers that we've learned to pull to drive change much more effectively than we thought possible before. The main one I'm going to talk about is methane, a potent greenhouse gas that's responsible for 30% of the warming we currently experience. But when I changed directions, methane was largely unlooked at. CO2 was a focus. It's critically important. And we were making great progress on renewable energy. But the challenge was that wasn't enough. And with addressing of methane, we could slow the rate of warming significantly over the next few decades, which would allow us to start to slow down those changes I was seeing in the forest. In order to effectively make those changes, we needed better data. So we organized an effort among hundreds of scientists to collect data on methane emissions, of which we knew very little, across the US related to oil and gas industry. And that allowed us to create a much clearer picture of what was going on. But we realized we couldn't do this everywhere around the world. In order to create that level of data, we needed to go to space. We needed to be able to understand what was happening and answering three basic questions. Where were the emissions? How much were the emissions? And how are they changing over time? I want to talk about what we've done to answer those three questions.
You can't solve the climate crisis without reducing methane emissions.
We really didn't understand how much of the natural gas that was being drilled and delivered was being lost to the atmosphere. We are going to be focused on one thing, getting high-quality data that could create much greater clarity about the nature of methane emissions.
For the first time, policymakers and the public can really understand not only the magnitude of emissions, but also where these emissions are coming from, the countries and companies most responsible, and hold them accountable.
Methane emissions.
Methane emissions.
Methane emissions.
Methane emissions.
Methane emissions.
Methane emissions. Methane emissions.
Mitigating methane emissions allows us to bring rapid progress towards addressing the climate crisis while we deal with the long-term climate crisis that we face.
We're going to do something that nobody has ever been able to do before.
There's no better vantage point to view methane emissions than from space. And this is the critical, crucial moment in climate change and fighting it, that we need this data, we need this transparency.
Measuring methane to this precision, you have to design and develop a new technology that does that.
Observations of the sophistication that will be made by MethaneSat were previously only available if governments chose to pursue them. This is a fantastically capable instrument, and that has just been outside of what's possible.
Three, two,
We've never had this quality data for any greenhouse gas, full stop. This is a revolution.
We will make a significant difference in climate change immediately.
We can change the course of global warming in our lifetime.
We know exactly what we need to do to solve the climate crisis.
Could go back one, please? So we launched the rocket with methane sat. We didn't. SpaceX launched the rocket, but it had methane sat on it a few months ago. And we're on track to collect that data to really create a clarity that we've never had before. But the key is that we needed to do two really big things to accomplish that. We needed a more precise greenhouse gas measuring satellite than had ever been launched before. We brought in a whole host of partners to do that. And we needed to process the data to produce it in a policy-relevant way. Currently, satellites produce data that tell you the concentrations of those greenhouse gases, which doesn't tell you give you the information to answer my three questions. Where are the emissions, how much are they, and how are they changing over time? So we were able to work with a wide range of partners to do this. We were working with funding from the Bezos Earth Fund, working with great institutions and researchers doing cutting-edge work to build this system and put it into space, including the New Zealand Space Agency, who is a partner which is running the satellite right now as we speak. They're operating the satellite. We did a complete cloud-based system. And we're going to be looking at emissions around the world. These are just a target list so that we can quantify oil and gas from every major basin in the world and make that public. All the data will be public. And we can understand who's performing well and who is not. And in the interim, before we have that data up, we are going to be able to process, because we had to build this pipeline, this data processing system that didn't exist. Nobody had it. So we created a jet, we modified it, and we flew an instrument comparable to what we have in space to allow us to collect high-quality data, just like we'd get out of the satellite, that would allow us to perfect this software, to build this factory, as we call it, so that everyone will be able to go and look up this data. You'll be able to know who's producing what. And we're also working with New Zealand to do the same for agriculture. These are some of the data that we've collected with the plane in Utah and the Uinta Basin. And what you see for the first time is data. Those colors represent the intensity of methane. You have the total amount of methane, you have the intensity of where it's being emitted, and you see there are very few large point sources. We'll have this data from about 25 places on the Earth every day of the year for the next several years. And not all of them look alike. So this is from the Permian Basin, the biggest oil and gas producing region in the US. You see, it looks very different because it is very different. And this is the kind of data we need for all greenhouse gases, for all locations, and we don't have it. This is a revolution. We can only do it from space, and we in the United States are at the advantage. We have access to the best technology in the world. Literally the best. This is allowing us to do this. So I'll end by talking about, as I mentioned, all this data will be available to all of you, any non-commercial users, free of charge, and it will be easy to understand and to utilize. And this is part of the vision of the radical transparency we need going forward if we're going to meet the challenge before us. And we're doing this with many partners, including the UN Environment Program, International Methane Emissions Observatory. And together, we can create the revolution that will allow action to happen at a scale we never could have imagined. Thank you very much.